Hello, welcome. My name is Kwabena Obeng Darko. Welcome. I want to share today with you, start small as a business person, as an entrepreneur. Start small. Please subscribe to this channel, share the channel with your friends and people you think will be interested in what we share here. So my name is Kwabena Obeng Darko. Start small. Most people think of business, and usually they think of something that is, you know, they have to have a very nice office, they have to have a car, they have to have a secretary, they have to have a receptionist, they have to have a very strong team. If you have never done any business before, and if you don't have a lot of the resources, if you don't have a lot of money, the best way to start your business is to start small. Just like many things in this world, the forest, the tree, they all started small. Even you as a human being, you started small as a seed in your mother's womb. You know, so you have to think like that. There are so many principles in life that we can all learn from, and just with business as well. Because when you start small, then you can start with anything that you have. You know, you can start with 1 city, 10 cities. Instead, you are thinking of becoming a big owner of properties. Start small. You don't have to go and build 100 unit apartment when you don't have it. Even though you are starting small, you still have very big dream. You are thinking of how great, how giant you will become. But every step, they say, starts with one. One step. Every journey starts. They say that some cities were not built in a day. So start small. When you start small, then you are going to have the time to learn all the things that are required for any business to work. You know, you are going to build your network, you're going to learn how to manage the money, you are going to learn about the market, you're going to learn how to structure your business, how to build the systems, how to even employ people, the right ones, the bad ones, how to deal with government institutions, how to, you know, pay your tax and understand the tax things that are in, you know, all the tax components, the insurance, the municipal levies that we pay, there's fire service, all the various things that we are committed. You know, when you don't have any business and you just have some job somewhere, you are sitting somewhere, you don't have any problem. The moment you start a business, you know, somebody, they can even say you have not paid tax, you know, you are a criminal, just because you start a business. So you want to start it and learn all the components of business, especially when you come from a background that you have never done business before. Even if when you have money, I will still submit that you begin small, because then you are going to learn a lot. And so when you start small and you even fail, it's not that difficult to, you know, to restructure or to leave the business and start another one, because it's not the commitment is not that much in terms of resources, in terms of money. But when you want to start and you start at a very high level, especially those who would want to borrow money and put it in a very big thing, in a very big business that they have no expertise in. For instance, if you know, have no idea in how maybe they build a mining company, and you go to the bank and you take 10 million, you know, because you have other things that you can raise the money, and you go and put it in a mining company big, and you have no expertise in how a business is run, you have never put anything together, it's likely that you learn that at a very high cost. But when you start small, when you go into it, especially when you start, a lot of the times, businesses that you want to start by building the market for that which you have in mind. So you want to start property company. Maybe you can learn how to be an agent first. You know, you don't have much to start building properties, but you can learn how to be an agent. You want to be a big producer of cement. You know, that's your dream. Start by maybe having a shop that sells cement, and if you're able to build the outlets many times and you go into production, your probability or the probability that your business will be successful is very high, because then you have learned the trade to a very high level. You still would have a lot of things to learn, but then this is a good start. So let's say you want to build a school. Maybe you can go there and start small in your room and put some 2 children together, or maybe you even go and teach a little and learn how the trade is done. Everything that you have in mind as a business person, start small. It's so you have a lot of advantages when you can go anywhere and just pick a little and learn. That is the way to go. When people are thinking of, you know, how to put a nice business plan together, how to do your finances, go and get an accountant, those are very impressive. When you have a lot of money, you have a lot of resources, you have done businesses, a lot of them before. But if you don't have anybody to help you, if you don't have any network, then the best business plan is just starting small and understanding the model, understanding the market, and adding up as you continue. Because the people are going to give you the feedback. The market will speak to you. The market is always going to speak to you. The market is always going to speak to you. So if you're not an expert, then start small. Even the experts, whenever they want to go into something new, a lot of the times, even though that business may require millions, they will still want to, you know, put in some few thousands and see how things work before they start to commit a lot. Because the only reason you have to commit a lot of resources, a lot of money into a business is when there is the demand already. There is the need for the business. People are asking for it. Maybe you started to produce, let's say, shirt like what I'm wearing. You know, you don't have to go and produce thousands of them and put them down when you have no market marketing channels, you have no sales channels, you have nothing. You just, now you're going to beg people to even take your product and keep them there before they pay you. No, maybe you start with one, you start to two, you start to get people to understand that this is what you can produce. And once they keep asking beyond your friends, then it means that there is a need for that. You know, then you can go and look for money because there is a specific need. You don't go and look for money and put it in a business where nobody is asking you for any product, any service. So start small. My name is Kwabena Darko. I'm sharing with you today about start small. You might have a very, you know, big vision. You maybe want to build a business that is all over the world. That's no problem. But you still have to take the first step. And a lot of the times, starting small can also handle the fear. Most people are afraid of risk, of loss. You know, they don't want to lose money at all. So if you have 10,000 and you don't want to lose all, then maybe start with 500 Ghana cedis, you know. And once you start, and you start to see, because you will see where the money must go. But if you go and put all your 10,000 into it, a lot of the times you will lose it. You know, in as much as we say that business is risky, and it is risky, you will lose some, you know. But if you go with this caution, a lot of the times you lose because you don't understand, because you don't have the expertise to manage all the various components of business. You know, you cannot just be a master of a product. You have to be a master of the team, a master of money, a master of a lot of things that you're that, you know, you have to even, you have to become an expert in a lot of things, so to say, or have a general knowledge in a lot of things for the business to work. So before the business will pick and start to shoot, you would have learned a lot of the lessons. Because when you start small, that's why most people who started their businesses when they were young, when the time that they were making a lot of the mistakes, nobody saw them. So when you see them in their 30s and they're very successful, it's because they started early. You know, they started making all the mistakes, the errors, the losses, the disappointments, the betrayals, you know, the sleepless nights. But they started them when they were very young, so there was energy. So start small. If you start small, you will grow. And everything starts small. If you, what makes the business grow? What will make the business grow will be your commitment, your the hard work, your honesty, the things that you are understanding on the business, the market, the teams that you put together, how you're able to lead them, how you're able to manage them. A lot of things that most people focus on, like the office, the car, the branding, the radio advert or the Facebook advert and all those, they are good. But those are not the drivers of successful businesses. The drivers of successful businesses are the team, the skill set, the leader, your understanding, your expertise of the market, of the money, of a lot of things that will have to move the business to the next stage. So start small, think big, start small, but always think big, look far, and look far beyond your basic restrictions now. But always start small. It is far easier to push yourself to start than to wait for a very big one before you start. I never think that everything would have to be very smooth, everything would have to be very perfect for you to start. They say that your wisdom will come when you start. Oh, wisdom is proof. It's in the courage to start. Always. And when you are starting small, the courage required will not be that much, because the losses will not be very much, you know. But then you will have the potential to learn so much, you know. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much. Subscribe to this channel. Share the channel with your friends and your families. I thank you.